And we can't, you know, it's interesting. I was really excited to be here because you can't do these projects on your own. And so I do have to spend a little bit of time at the beginning just thanking all of our partners that are really helping us create this vision here at Skyline Apartments. We're excited about what this is going to mean for the community and the opportunities that it's really going to help for our city. When we look at how do we maintain ourselves competitive, how do we maintain ourselves innovative, and creating these new affordable housing units. So Mayor's vision is very clear. We have to create that 20,000 units by 2026. We are keenly focused on that goal, and we are going to reach there. And we can't also but thank the state as well. State Commissioner has been very, very supportive of us, and I know he's not here, but if you see him, Commissioner Nunn, please ensure that he knows that we are thankful to him. And then our council member, and Council Member Winston, I know you're here. I just want to specifically thank you. We can't do this without council member support for everything in terms of just community involvement and zoning and just support. So cannot thank you enough, Cheryl, for everything you guys have done to make this project real and your commitment to affordable housing. That is really going to move the needle here. And the Beltline, you know, we have a lot of partners. The Atlanta Beltline, really, their team is amazing and is really excited to come together and to leverage each other's support so that we can create the affordable housing units and the goal we both share in ensuring that we are meeting the demands. Okay, and at Invest Atlanta, so Vicky gets a formal shout out from me. Thank you, Vicky. She is amazing. She can get things done and moving at Invest Atlanta. As you can see, Dawn Arnold is not here, but her vision as well to ensure affordable housing has been in the industry and space. Teresa, Kiera, Tremaine, Krista, Rita, Bernita. Yeah, it takes a team to actually move this forward. So really excited about what that will mean for this. So Invest Atlanta has been able to create about 1,607 affordable housing units in the last year. So we have really focused on how do we create more units at deeper levels of AMI. And in fact, 25% of all of the housing, affordable housing units are at that 60% AMI. So really focused in on how do we provide housing. And not only that, we know that about 70%, okay, pre-COVID, about 70% of people wake up in one county and then move to another. So, Kali, I'm super excited to meet you finally. Been working with your amazing team led over there by Jacob to really think about public transit. So we know the average family spends about 70% as well of their income on housing and transportation. So if you're able to lower those costs, you're able to make the largest impact on someone's life. So not only do we want to make it efficient and effective for them to travel, but also a place to stay and then to spend more money on needed essentials to helping survive here in the city of Atlanta with all of our expenses that we have and an average household. We've also started our housing opportunity bond, which was another $50 million to support affordable housing. So it's exciting that this together, not only do we have the finance, we have the vision, but we have the commitment really led by this mayor to focus on more affordable housing here in our city. So what, how about this project in particular? So 200 working families are going to be able to be supported at 60% AMI for affordable housing, 20 years here in Peoplestown, which will be amazing. But what is the economic impact? $98 million. Well, there you go. That just shortened my speech, Mayor. $98 million in terms of economic impact when you're looking at these type of projects. So that is not only direct, indirect, but induced. And this will be important for us as we move forward. So let me just, now that our phenomenal guest has arrived, Mayor, want to just say that I am excited about the opportunity to really do another groundbreaking on affordable housing, looking at, really appreciate council member and all of our partner support. And I almost forgot to mention Dale. LISC has been amazing for us as a partner as well. And I just want to thank Dale, who was an Invest Atlanta alum, and now he's off running LISC here. And so just want to thank you for your continual partnership as well, Dale. So with that, Mayor, let me introduce you and thank you for your commitment to affordable housing. You have a great amount of partners here, and just look forward to creating more units and hitting your goal by 2026.
All right, good, thank you. Thank you. Hey. Good. It's still morning. Good morning, everybody. It's good to see y'all. This came up faster today than they told me it was. They had me for about 30 minutes after this, and we said, well, just come on down and get there early, and didn't get here early. This is already in motion. So it's good to see Councilmember Winston here. This district is special to him, and he's the District 1 council member, and his leadership is outstanding and already off to a good start. Thank you, Dr. Clementich, for introducing me and getting us started today. I'm excited. You know, affordable housing gets me going. This is my thing. This is what I've cut my teeth on, getting started in the city council after 8 years, and then now as mayor, we have some ambitious goals, and we plan to hit them all. And to know that all 250 of these rental units will be reserved as affordable housing is just fantastic. 250 units where families will be able to thrive in this city is important to us. We know that here in Atlanta, we have some sort of become a victim of our own success, as the fact that we have grown in this city is such a desirable landing spot for people to come to means that our supply of affordable housing is critically low. And it's a great place to be. So many people want to call it home, but not at the expense of our working families. We have to make sure that we allow room for our families and our legacy residents. And all 250 of these units being reserved as affordable for at least 15 years gives me hope in this corridor as we go forward. My administration has committed to an ambitious goal of 20,000 units of affordable housing being built or preserved over the next 8 years. And we plan to hit every last one of those and exceed it. So this Skyline Apartments moves us closer to that goal. Starting with 250 is a way that you get to 20,000. You have to do it bit by bit, and you guys are helping us do that. So congratulations to the Beltline COO, Ruben Brooks is here, and his Atlanta Beltline Incorporated team for exceeding 50% of their affordable housing goal right now with these Skyline units that's going to be built. This helps the Beltline get just over the 50% mark of the goal that has been set by the Beltline board. So I'm excited, and you know, congratulations to the Beltline for that. This is a great day for us, and it will be an even greater day when we're able to return here after it's built to these Skyline Apartments. And I plan to be here for both this groundbreaking and for the ribbon cutting, and you know, to enjoy what's yet to come. I've said it before. Great things can come when we have the right partnerships. And there are a lot of partnerships at the table as we develop this, whether that's the funders, Invest Atlanta, LISC, and so many others. You know, we got MARTA here. This is the way that you do things in the city of Atlanta, to be able to have partnerships is how you get it done. Just a few weeks ago, I think it was 2 weeks ago, we were in Reynoldstown, a neighborhood just a little ways up the street, breaking ground on another affordable housing unit along the Beltline, where Atlanta Beltline Incorporated partnered with Invest Atlanta and Atlanta Housing Authority to be able to make it happen. And it also is 100% affordable. Invest Atlanta's CEO, Dr. Clementich, is right on task and being able to be committed to making these things possible from incentives perspectives. But then we have all these other partnerships. So I'm just thankful and excited, and I'm ready to be here to go put some shovels in the dirt for us to get this groundbreaking underway. It's good to see all of you all. Thank you.
I ran a campaign, and the number one thing I talked about was affordable housing in that campaign. And so this is part of that dream that I've had for this community. I'm also, like Raj mentioned, from a big town of about 3,000 people, 80 miles south of here, called West Point, Georgia. And in that community, we had school teachers. We had police and firefighters that lived in the community that helped raise people like myself, because you saw them on a daily basis. And about 22 years ago, I actually moved just north of here on Capitol Avenue at 450 Capitol Avenue when I moved to the city of Atlanta. And so this too is my home. And I'm excited about the opportunity to see school teachers, firefighters, police officers, grocery store workers have the opportunity to live right here in this community. There's a school across the street. There's so many people that are going to benefit from this. And I'm excited about all the partnerships that made this happen. And I have an 18-month-old daughter, and Zoo Atlanta is in my district. and she talks about big cats. Where Daddy's also excited about big cats. And those are the big yellow cats that you see behind me that are going to be doing lots of great development in this district. And I know the mayor, he talks a lot about circles. Well, we can't truly have circles if our school teachers, our firefighters, and our police officers aren't in that same circle. And so this development does that, and I thank each and every one of you that helped make this a reality. So thank you very much.
One, two, three.